Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Distinguished guests, Lord Mayor, Lady Mayoress, and to the players who are waiting quietly over there in the corner. I'm very fortunate. I've been in my post now with Bucks just for 6 months, and I reckon I've probably got the best job in the world. And when you come to an event like this, on an evening like this, I think probably you'll agree with me. So on behalf of Bucks, the National University Sports Federation of Great Britain, and on behalf of the amazing team who's put this event together, which includes Swansea University, the City of Swansea, the Welsh Rugby Union, and FISU, I'm delighted to welcome you to the FISU Rugby Sevens, the first FISU Championships in the UK since 2002. Rugby plays a very important part in our Bucks programme in terms of competitive sport, and also within the UK, and it remains one of our largest and strongest sports. Probably best not to mention the English football, but I couldn't go without wishing Wales good luck this evening in their game against Portugal. Thank you, fellas. And clearly, the Welsh football team have learnt an awful lot from the rugby teams of our home nations around that teamwork and spirit. And teamwork is just one of the values that rugby teaches, along with integrity, respect and enjoyment, which every player hopefully draws from being part of a rugby team. The FISU Rugby Sevens is very much a key stepping stone for many of the senior Sevens players, certainly within England, who go on and hopefully within Wales as well, will be in contention for a place in the Rio Olympics this summer. And finally, on behalf of Bucks, I'd like to offer my sincere thanks and gratitude to Swansea University as the hosts for their support in delivering what we hope will be a world-class event, but we know will be fantastic. And I hope that we all enjoy some amazing rugby over the next few days. And to the players, via their coaches, I would just say good luck and play well. Thank you.
Thank you very much there. That was Vince May. We are now, I think, about ready to welcome out the competing teams. Please show your support for this year's 2016 competing teams. With one championship appearance, ranking 7th place in 2014 Brazil. Rugby is considered the second most popular sport in Argentina, behind football of course. Argentina ranked 5th in IRB World Rankings. Following Argentina, we have Australia, represented this year by both the men and women's teams. First appearance of the men's by Australia in the WC Rugby Sevens. The Australian National Rugby Sevens team has qualified for the 2016 Olympics, and the men's national rugby team are nicknamed the Wallabies. We also have the women's team. 7 of the women on the team are from Queensland, Australia, and their team is nicknamed the Wallaroos. Okay, next up, we have Canada, represented by the women's team this year. They've had 6 championship appearances, ranking highest place 2 in 2006 at Italy. The Canadian women have won the WC Rugby Sevens title more than any other team, and unprecedented 3 times. They've also never placed below 5th in any of their WC Rugby Sevens appearances. That's Canada women's. Okay, following Canada, we have the People's Republic of China. They're represented by their women's team this year. They've had 3 championship appearances, ranking 3 in 2006 at Italy. The squad is comprised of girls from Beijing Normal University, and they see this as a revisit to Swansea University, as the two institutions have very close rugby connections. China entered 2 teams, in fact, in 2004. Next up, we have the Czech Republic, represented this year by the men's team, the only team from Eastern Europe to attend this year's championship. The Czech Republic national team has been around since 1993, after the breakup of Czechoslovakia. Okay, following them, we have France, represented by both men and women's teams this year. The men's have appeared in championship appearances 5 times, with their highest rank in 2004. They placed first and also at Italy in 2006. They've won the first 2 World University Championship Rugby Sevens titles and have never placed below 3rd in a WC competition. We also have the women's team. They've made 4 appearances, ranking 2nd at 2012 France and 2014 Brazil. The University of Paris French Women's Rugby Sevens team are the current European Universities Rugby Sevens champions. Okay, also represented by men's and women's teams, next we have Italy. The men's team has appeared 4 at championship level, highest ranking 6 in 2006 at Italy. They've competed in every WEC Rugby Sevens that's taken place in Europe for a total of 4 appearances. We also have the women's team. They've made 4 appearances, highest ranking 2nd at 2006 Italy. They've also never placed below 5th in any of their appearances in the WEC Rugby Sevens. Following Italy, we have Japan this year, represented by their women's team. They've made 2 appearances, with their highest ranking of 4th in 2012. Rugby was officially introduced to Japanese students as far back as 1899, and their national team is nicknamed the Cherry Blossoms. Applause going. We're going to welcome Malaysia, represented this year by the men's team. Malaysia is one of 3 men's teams in this year's Rugby Championship that have also competed in the first Rugby Sevens in China. They've appeared in the championship 4 times with a higher ranking of 7 in 2004. And next we have up the only African country to compete in this year's championship. We have Namibia. They've made 2 championship appearances with a highest ranking of 6 in 2014. The Namibian rugby team is also nicknamed the Wiltshires. We have New Zealand. They're represented this year by their women's team. This is the first time New Zealand has competed in the WEC Rugby Sevens, and although they are known as a very dominant rugby nation, rugby is the number 1 sport in New Zealand, and the national team's nickname is the All Blacks. Okay, represented by women's team also we have Portugal. They've made 1 championship appearance with a very high ranking of 3 in 2010. This is Portugal winning 2nd appearance in the WC Rugby Sevens. Their previous attempt was 2010 in Porto. Okay, represented by men's and women's, we have Spain. The men's have made 5 championship appearances with the highest placing of 2nd in 2008, which took place in Spain. The National Sevens team is one of the 15 core teams that compete in each event in the IRB 7 World Series. Spain's women's team have made 3 championship appearances with the highest places of 1 in both 2008 and 2010. They're the only women's team to win the WEC Rugby Sevens title on home soil. Okay, and finally, we're going to welcome out United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, represented by the men's and women's team. The men have made 5 championship appearances with a high ranking of 1 in 2012 and 2014. They finished 4th in the 2015 Sevens World Series, qualified them for the 2016 Olympics. And of course we have the women's team. The English women's rugby team beat Canada in 2014 World Cup in France, which means they're the current world champions. Okay, ladies. and gentlemen, we now ask that you stand for the national anthem of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. Okay, we're now going to welcome up the Pro Vice Chancellor of Swansea University. Please give a warm welcome to Professor Steve Wilkes.
Bonaddigion a bonaddigesau, gwestion a chefilian arbennig. Ladies, gentlemen, distinguished guests and friends, on behalf of the organising committee, I'm truly delighted to welcome you to Wales, to Swansea and to Swansea University, on this historic evening that marks the hosting of these championships in the United Kingdom for the first time. In particular, I'm honoured to welcome the players and the teams who will take part in this week's World University Championships. Many of you have travelled great distances to be here, and whilst you all have the special honour of representing your country on the world stage, for some of you this is the first time that your country has been represented at this event. The diversity, culture, and passion that you bring to this event will help ensure that the championships are an unforgettable experience for everyone involved. Swansea University is serious about sport, and sport is at the heart of the university life. It provides great opportunity, outstanding experiences, and brings together thousands of students week in, week out, adding to the depth of their experience gained during their time at university. The university has a fantastic sporting history and an outstanding record of success. Nowhere is such history and success more evident in the sport of rugby, a sport that binds us and inspires us as a nation. Our commitment to sport and the opportunities we develop for students to learn, practice, compete, ensures we consistently produce international stars across the range of all sports. This commitment to sport and passion for rugby means we're immensely proud to host these championships, which represent the very highest level of student sport in the world. The next few days will undoubtedly inspire a future generation. The organising committee, including Swansea University, British University Colleges and Sports, and the Welsh Rugby Union, have worked tirelessly over the last 3 years in preparing for these championships, ensuring that the environment and facilities within which the 20 teams we have with us tonight will eat, sleep, train and compete are befitting of a world-class competition. For many of you, this will be the pinnacle of your sporting career so far, and I sincerely hope that when the championships are over and you leave Swansea to return home to your families across the globe, that you look back over these few days proudly and fondly and remember the part you played in this great event. I hope you all enjoy every moment of these championships and the time in our beautiful city of Swansea and our rugby nation of Wales. Thank you and good luck. Diolch a poblwch.
Professor Steve Wilkes. Okay, next up, we're going to welcome up FISU Executive Committee member. Please keep the applause going, Colleen Dufresne.
Lord Mayor, Lady Mayoress, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a pleasure and an honor, on behalf of FISHU President Oleg Matteson and the Executive Committee, to welcome you to the 7th World University Rugby Championships, Rugby Sevens Championships. This tournament falls only 31 days prior to the Olympic Games. Congratulations to all the student athletes who've earned the right to represent their country. You should all be very proud. Over the next few days, we'll be treated to high caliber competition by 10 women and 9 men's teams representing all 5 continents. I'd like to thank the match officials who ensure fairness and impartiality throughout the tournament. I extend a sincere thank you to the Welsh Rugby Union, WRU, to Bucks, and to Swansea University for hosting this great event. Lastly, thank you to all the organizing committee and the volunteers, without whom an event like this could not take place. Best of luck to all the teams. Compete hard, do your best, and enjoy the wonderful Welsh hospitality. Thank you. Diolch.
Okay, and finally, we would now like to welcome up the Right Worshipful Mayor of the City and County of Swansea.
Ladies and gentlemen, as Lord Mayor of this wonderful city, it is a great pleasure for me to stand before you today and welcome you from all around the world. And I'm passionate about sport, and particularly rugby. But tonight, I think it's your day, and I think what we must remember, you must play hard, work hard, but you must also enjoy it. What I want you to leave this fine city with a fond memory of our hospitality, our culture, and the wonderful coastline. So it's important that you look around the city in your spare time. Please go back to your families, your friends, and I want you to remember this city as being one of the most hospitable and friendly cities, because that's what we are. The weather isn't always this good, I must admit. It's staying dry at the moment, but let's hope the weather holds out for you. So it is my complete and utter pleasure to officially open these games this evening and wish you very fine games. But to thank the organisers, 3 years in planning. An event like this don't take place overnight. So it's 3 years in planning. So I think it's important that we remember the organisers that have put the voluntary work into this over the last 3 years. But thank you very much. It's my great pleasure to officially open these games. Thank you.
Thank you very much, the Lord Mayor. Okay, then, ladies and gentlemen, once again we ask you to stand, this time for the FISHU anthem.
Thank you.
Okay, we're now going to welcome up the athletes, a representative of the athletes and the judges for the oaths. First of all, a member of the Women's French IRB team, silver medalist with the French University team in WC Brazil 2014. Please give a warm welcome, Lene Corson.
Gotcha.
Sorry. On behalf of all of the student athletes, I promise that we shall take part in the championship respecting and abiding by the rules which govern them, committing ourselves to a sport without doping and without drugs in the true spirit of sportsmanship. Fair play for the glory of our country, for the honor of our teams, and for the achievement of international university sports movement.
A lot taller than me. Okay, and now we're going to welcome up Hong Kong Rugby Union as a referee development officer, referee with Hong Kong Sevens World Series qualifier tournament. Please show a warm welcome, Patrick Kwok.
In the name of all the judges and officials, I promise that we shall officiate in this championship with complete impartiality, respecting and abiding by the rules which govern it in the true spirit of sportsmanship.
Okay, before we carry on then, can we have a big round of applause for all our guest speakers today? We're going to finish the opening ceremony off in style with some entertainment for you. Please keep the applause going as we welcome out Morriston Rugby Male Voice Choir. As they make their way over, once again, a big thank you to all the organisers, speakers today, and of course the volunteers, without whom none of this would have been possible. There's quite a few of them. And then performing for you now, Morriston Rugby Male Voice Choir.
Oh.
ladies and gentlemen, Morriston Rugby Male Voice Choir. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we would like to thank you for attending the ceremony, and I'm sure you'll join me in wishing all the teams good luck for the tournament. We hope you enjoy your stay in Swansea. Thank you very much, Diolch yn fawr.